Am I not audible? Okay, any doubt so far? अभी तक कोई किसी को doubt है? From the points which I have already told to you, जो भी point मैंने आपको बताए हैं उसमें किसी को doubt है कुछ भी? You can tell me. You can just type in the chat box. Or you can just write no or no if you don't have any doubt. Okay, for as of now I am assuming you don't have any doubt. Sonam is saying, will there be any study material for topics which are already uploaded in the dashboard? Yes, you will get the study material by Sunday on all the topics. So basically what I will be doing, I will be uploading the study material of the previous session, so that if you want to cover those topics from those notes, you can cover from there. Otherwise, we will anyways be covering all those topics through the live classes and through the updated study material. Okay? So, when I am putting the old lectures and old notes, that does not mean that I will not take the live classes of those topics. Okay? So, aap logo ko ye sochne ki zarurat nahi hai ki live class nahi hongi. The live classes will be there. Right? Any other doubt by anyone? Okay. Now, so let us start with the topic self-help groups, right? And take out your pen and paper and start writing the question. So here is the list of questions. So these are the three questions which have been asked in the UPSC exam. One question was asked in 2017, then in 2014, and before that in 2013. So three times from 2012, from 2013 onwards, when this syllabus was changed, three times this topic has been asked. Teen baar ye topic pucha ja chuka hai, theek hai? So please start reading the question and you will get 4 minutes for each question. You will get how much time? 4 minutes for each question. You can brainstorm and keep a paper and pen with yourself. Start writing the key points. After 12 minutes, I will give you an opportunity. Two people will get an opportunity to tell their answers for each question. Right? So that will help us in brainstorming and working in the collaborative manner. So your time starts now. Aapka time abhi start hota hai. It just Yeah. So your 4 minutes start now. 1st question. Please maintain the time limit. So read the question carefully and in the 4 minutes write down the important points. So let us see some of the basic points of the self-help groups. Self-help groups are the informal groups. That means they are not supposed to be registered. They are informal, and normally their size is 10 to 20 individuals. As per the government survey, more than 65% of the SHGs, they have less than 10 members. So what is the benefit of having less members? The benefit is that they can have close knit group and they can be participating completely. So having the small group, gives them opportunity to participate fully. Now, they have the homogeneous background. That means if a person is craft person or a farmer or a maid or driver, so they can have their own self-help groups separately. Craft person, they can have their own self-help group. Farmers, they can have their own self-help group. Maids, they can have their own self-help group, like that. So this homogeneity of the social and economic background, that is, they belonging to the common social and economic background, that gives them opportunity to discuss on the common problems which they face. So they better understand the world of each other, and they are able to contribute to each other's problems much more actively. They come together actively for promoting the saving habit. This saving habit is very, very important. This is the base of this self-help group, right? So for any self-help group to be recognized by the NABARD, if any self-help group want to take the advantage of the NABARD program, then it has to participate, it has to start from savings of its own members. The savings can start from rupees 10 only or rupees 1 only. The amount of saving is not important, but the point is that they have to show that they are self-funded initially. They have to be active for 6 months. Wo 6 months ke liye active rahenge, right? They have to be active for 6 months before NABARD can give them some kind of advantage. And they will be having the common course to raise and manage the resources for the common benefit of group members. So this common course is very, very important. Common course is basically to collect the money, pool the money, and give the loan to the member itself without any collateral, at a very low rate of interest, and the return of loan is also very, very disciplined. The recovery rate of these self-help groups is also very, very disciplined. Okay. So as per NABARD, this is the definition of the self-help group. Otherwise, if we see conceptually, self-help group are the self-governed groups. It means they have their own leaders. One of the person from among themselves is the head of the self-help group, right? And all the other members, they have the equal sharing as well as equal voting power in the functioning of the self-help group. This is peer controlled. That means when loan is given, then they do not worry about the recovery of the loan, because under the peer pressure, the person is obliged to return back the money. Group of people with a similar socio-economic background, I already told you, the drivers, they can have their own self-help group. Craftsmen, they can have their own self-help group, and they have a common purpose. The common purpose can be just to save the money or maybe to start some enterprise. So common purpose can be any, but they have the common purpose. Now, as you can see, as per the NABARD, these are the features which I have already discussed. Homogeneous background, active for 6 months. They have successfully undertaken savings and credit operations. and they are democratically working. That means all of the members have the equal power. They have proper accounting and they have a genuine need to participate and help each other. Basic principles, they are lending on a demand base. So if any member requires the loan, the SFL group can give the loan. This loan is collateral free and this is poor friendly. That means the rate of interest is very, very low. So rate of interest is in most of the cases less than 6%. Less than 6% is the rate of interest. They are basically focusing upon the capacity building. This is also very, very important. So not only they are saving and collecting the money, but they are training the members in the skill development, in the organizational skills, in the leadership skills. They have the joint discussion. So all of these things work in the self-help group. The money can be given as a loan for the dependents' education, household consumption, acquiring the assets, self-employment, medical treatment, repaying the debt. My friends, you might feel that these are the very basic things, right? What is there special about the self-help group? So in the absence of self-help group, we can understand the importance of self-help group, right? So in the absence of self-help group, if any poor person required the money for any of these purposes, for the education, for the household consumption, for acquiring the assets, for self-employment, for medical treatment, for repaying the debt, then they have to go to the private money lender, right? This private money lender, they will be first giving the rate of interest more than 10%. Then they will be also requiring the collateral security. Then they will be manipulating the accounts, right? So it becomes very, very exploitative for the poor person. So these self-help groups are actually avoiding all this exploitation of the poor person. So this is very, very important. We should appreciate the role of these self-help group, that they are providing the microfinancial services. Microfinancial services means they are providing the small loan, they are providing the facility of small insurance, small loan, small insurance, awareness about the banking operation, how to open the bank account, how to take the loan, and they are actually giving the confidence to the members. So they are playing very, very important role. So you can see why members participate in the self-help group. They develop the savings habit. So even if they contribute just 10 rupees on a daily basis, in 1 year they are able to contribute 3650 rupees, and with interest this amount can become 5000 rupees, which is a very, very big amount for the self-help group member. They also get access to the credit facilities. They develop the quality of self-reliance, and they also get social political empowerment. We will discuss how. Now if we see the historical evolution of the self-help group, we can see from the 1970, the SEWA, that is the Self-Employed Women's Association, it was the first self-help group which has been very, very successful also, right? So it brought together the self-employed women, and it pooled the resources, pooled the expertise of each other. They complemented, they became the voice of these women, and it is very, very successful. After that, in 1985, the NGO Mysore Settlement and Development Agency, that is a MYREDA, it established various informal groups on the model of self-help. And within 1 year, that is 1986-1987, there were around 300 self-help groups which were working under the projects. In 1992, the NABARD came up with self-help groups. It started promoting through the linkage program, and in the 9th five-year plan, the government recognized. So 9th five-year program, it started in 1997. In this program, the government recognized formally the concept of self-help group, and it started inviting the women for participating in the self-help group. So this is the historical background of the self-help group. Now, role of self-help group. So let us see the role of self-help groups. और सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स, सो बेसिकली मैनी ऑफ यू हैव टोल्ड वेरी गुड पॉइंट्स अबाउट द रोल ऑफ द सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स. If we see the role of self-help group, we can categorize into five areas, right? So I want to tell you one point here, that whenever you are giving the answer to such type of question, don't start directly from the points, whatever point you have in your mind. You should first build a perspective, right? What is the meaning of perspective? Building the perspective means that first, you should categorize your points in the broad categories. That will give you a structured answer. And the examiner will be impressed that you are not just bombarding the points which are coming to your mind, right? See friends, this pressure group topic is not a very unique topic. Aisa nahi hai ki aap agar meri class mein nahi aate to aapko pressure group samajh mein nahi aata. Right? It is very clear that this is not much conceptual topic, but what I want to tell you is that to get the maximum marks, you should organize your answer, organize your points in a very systematic manner. You should build the perspective. You should not write points just to increase the number of points in your answer. Right? Even if you write 10 points in this systematic format, the examiner will be impressed. Right? So, what are the different dimensions of the role of self-help group, or what is the importance of self-help group, or what is the role of self-help group in the development of the country? So it starts from the individual and family level, then at the society or community level, then the contribution to the governance level, contribution for the women's empowerment, and finally contribution to the financial and economic health of the country. So starting from the individual level, let us see. At the individual level, this self-help group promotes the savings. So savings can start from 10 rupees. Those savings are pooled and the need-based lending is done without any collateral. Out of this loan, as per the data, 95% of the loan is recovered. Right? So this self-help group has actually resulted into NPA free lending, as well as the you know thrift, the habit of thrift. Isko bolte hain thrift. Thrift ka matlab kya hota hai? Thrift means small small saving without impacting the day to day income of the person. So this saving can actually be used for the productive purpose. They have been contributing to the microfinance. Microfinance means the small finance, that is small deposits, small loan, small, you know, micro insurance, etc. So you might be knowing about the project of Grameen Bank in the Bangladesh, and the promoter of this bank, that is Mr. Yunus, he also got the award from the Nobel group. He is a Nobel awardee. In India, this microfinance function has been boosted by the self-help groups. Third, employment and livelihood. So when they have money, they can get the loan, then they are also involved into some kind of business activity. For example, the successful example of Lijit Papad, hai na? So this Lijit Papad got very very successful. It has given employment to lakhs of women. So it creates the livelihood opportunities. It contributes to the employment generation. This employment generation is at the decentralized level, which actually contributes to the balanced regional development also. It also promotes the banking literacy, and finally it leads to the financial inclusion, right? So the goal of financial inclusion also achieved. So this is the first category, right? This is the first category. So you should treat that this is a single point. in the exam hall, you can just write savings, comma, microfinance, comma, employment and livelihood, comma, banking literacy, like that. You're not supposed to write these points separately in the exam hall, because in the exam hall you will not have much of the space in your notebook, right? So try to comprehend the points so that your content is really very, very heavy and examiner is impressed in the exam hall. Now, the next question, sorry, next perspective, let us see. That is, what is the role in the development of individual and the family? When the person has access to the savings and the borrowings, the person feels confident, especially the woman. Okay? Especially the woman. So this self-help group gives them the confidence. When they have the confidence, they can participate in the decision making within the house. They can take the decision about the delivery of child. They can take the decision about basically institutional delivery. They can take the decision about education of the child, and they can take the decision about nutrition of the family. When they have the capability, then it also prevents them from the exploitation of domestic violence. It brings peace in the home, right? So these individuals and families, they are the basic unit of any society. If they are happy, it brings an all-inclusive development which contributes to the sustainable development goal, right? So it contributes to the sustainable development goal and also the inclusive growth. Inclusive growth, right? So you should try to interlink the common points with some broad area. Now, third is the governance. What is the contribution of self-help group in the governance? So self-help group, they have access to multiple government schemes. So many government schemes have been started for the self-help group. We will discuss about those schemes, and apart from that also, whatever other schemes are available to the individuals, they also become easily accessible by the self-help group members, because they have a common platform to discuss about the government schemes. They have friends and peers who can make them aware about their rights. So they have access to the government schemes, and when they regularly participate in the self-help group, the leaders of the self-help group, they start developing the leadership skill. Unki leadership skill develop start ho jati hai, and they start fighting the local level election. When they start fighting the local level election, a new generation of Panchayati Raj leaders has emerged, right? So it gives a training ground to the new generation to participate in the local self-government, that is in the panchayat especially. They also act as the pressure group, right? So they are also consulted by the government to make, while policy formulation is being done, while policy implementation is being done, right? They also contribute to the rural poverty alleviation, which is a very important goal of the government. And as they are decentralized, they are also contributing to the balanced regional development. Most importantly, because the small amount is being converted into the wealth, prosperity, domestic peace, it is giving the human face to the development, right? So all this ensures social, economic, political justice, which is also one of the goal of the constitution as well as one of the goal of the DPSP, right? So it strengthens the democracy, it strengthens the justice, and it gives more access to the opportunities to the individuals, right? So this is the contribution in the governance. After that, we have women empowerment. So when they participate in the self-help group, they improve their leadership skill. The social stigma that they cannot do anything apart from the household work is also minimized. They also take up other social responsibilities. The social responsibility to support the peer women, social responsibility to participate in the elections, right? And they also work on the common problem solving. They also help each other fight against the this domestic violence, against any other kind of exploitation. So it improves the gender relations. So it improves the gender relations, and it is quite visible from some of the very important indicators like improvement in the sex ratio, decrease in the total fertility rate, and increase in the institutional deliveries, right? So whenever we are giving some point, we can always try to give some kind of government data or some trends, right? So this is the trend: the sex ratio is improving, total fertility rate is decreasing, and institutional deliveries are also increasing. Now community development is also enhanced, because when people of the same background, they come together, they discuss their problem, they start participating in the at the community level, not at the individual level. It also promotes social integrity, because the people of different religious background, different caste background, they come together and they act as a single unit. So it also promotes the harmony. The problems like communal violence, all these problems can be resolved with the help of this self-help group. It gives voice to the marginalized people, those people who could not otherwise be heard in the you know, power corridors. And as they are involved in the local work, so their work is taken from the village level to the state level, then to the national level, and finally to the international level, which gives them the access to the international market and takes the culture of the rural area to the international level, right? So this kind of advancement is possible. It also helps them revive the rural art and culture, which could have been lost earlier. So they can work on their local traditions of, like, suppose pottery or other kind of local art and culture, painting, etc., right? So it also improves the rural art and culture. So these are the five perspectives you should write in the exam hall, right? So this is how we should write the answer. Now apart from that, in the recent, we can give some examples. For example, in the COVID times, during the COVID times, there are a lot of self-help groups who have been actively participating in the manufacturing of masks, PPEs, etc., sanitizer, distribution of food, etc. So even during the COVID-19, lot of stories have been coming in the newspapers that these self-help groups have been actively participating. There is a product of one of the self-help group in the Maharashtra, which provides the sanitary pads. So this takes care of the health of the hygiene and health of the women. So the name of the product is Ashmita Plus. Apart from that, for the success of the scheme One District One Product, the scheme of the government which was launched in the last year budget, the self-help group can actually prove to be very, very important vehicles. They can also be relied for the disposable bags, especially after the ban on the plastic bags in many states, right? So they can also contribute in the environmental conservation, right? So their role is very, very important. So we should try to, you know, write the answer in a comprehensive manner and try to cover all the areas, including the most recent areas. Now after this class, whenever you are reading the newspaper or you come across some news, write down that news in the notes of this class. So that will give you the comprehensive notes at the single place. Any doubt so far? किसी को doubt है कोई? Any doubt so far? You can ask. Okay, now what are the hurdles faced by the NGOs? NGOs के लिए क्या hurdles होती हैं? So let us see the hurdles faced by the NGOs. So we can divide the hurdles faced by the NGOs in the different categories. At the organizational level, what are the issues? What are the issues while dealing with the formal sector? And what are the other issues, right? So we should always try to divide the issues in different category as much as possible. This will give you more organized point and will make your answer very, very unique. So at the organizational level, they are not registered. That means they don't have proper backup from the side of government. They are not registered, right? So suppose we take the example of an NGO. Most of the NGOs, they are registered as a trust, as a cooperative society or something else. So this gives them credibility. These self-help group, because they are not registered, their credibility is not so much. Then it has been found that in many cases the accounting is very, very poor, and because of poor accounting the loan recovery becomes a problem. In many cases there is a misappropriation of fund also, so that also reduces the credibility of the self-help groups. Then lack of proper training. So they are interacting with the NABARD, they are interacting with the banks, they are interacting with the government functionaries, but they are not completely aware about the procedures, about their rights, about the systems. So it actually reduces the efficiency of the self-help group. It has been seen that in most of the cases these self-help groups are involved in the primitive activities. What is the meaning of primitive activities? That they are involved in the activities of primary sector, right? For example, animal husbandry, for example, fisheries, poultry, etc. So these primitive activities, it is good that they are being promoted, but at the same time the problem is that not much value addition is done from these primitive activities to the income of the individuals. See, if we have to really increase the per capita income of these self-help group members, those self-help group member should be involved in some manufacturing activity or in service sector, because in the manufacturing and service sector there is a high possibility of having high per capita income. But from these primitive activities